Okay guys, in this video I will talk about the detailing of slab reinforcement. I know this is not new to you, all of you may be familiar with this one, okay, but there is a major doubt for beginners, that is when we provide reinforcement in slab there is a specific criteria. What is that? That is, first you have to lay down your reinforcement along the shorter direction. This is the most confusing thing among all the beginners. Why it is that? Why shorter direction reinforcement should be placed first? Okay, so this is the topic of today's video. Okay, if you are new to this channel, please do subscribe and also press the bell icon so that in future you can be benefited. Okay, so let's start today's video. So the very first thing I would like to explain, that what will happen if we apply a load on a beam. This is the very basic thing. Okay, simply it will bend like this. Okay, not only that, here you can see that at the bottom it is tension and at the top it is compression, and you know that concrete is very much weak in tension, that is crack is going to occur at the bottom. Okay, I have repeated this many times. So to resist all this crack, what you have to do, simply you have to provide some reinforcement like this. Clear? No confusion? Okay. Now let's dive into the slab. Okay, so normally if we consider any two-way slab, okay, it looks something like this. Here you can see that along the blue beam it is shorter direction, or you can say that this is the shorter direction and the longer direction is along this red color beam. Okay, so how we are going to place the reinforcement? As I have already mentioned you, but first we are going to place the reinforcement along the shorter span or along the blue colored beam like this. Okay, then we are going to provide the reinforcement for longer span or along the red color beam like this. Okay, now why this is so? Okay, to understand this thing you have to understand the load travel concept. Okay, just consider the slab again. Okay, now let's say if you put any load above this slab at anywhere, at any location, how it is going to travel? How it is going to travel to the beam? What do you think? This load is going to where? To this beam? Or to this beam? Or to this beam? Or to this beam? Where it will go? Can you tell me? Or what about this load? Where it will go? This beam? Or to this beam? Or to this beam? Okay, so any load, it will always go to the shorter distance or to the nearest support. So for this load, it is going to this beam. Okay, for any load here, it is going to this beam. For any load here, it is going to this beam. Or this beam. Okay, so if we simply put all the load travel path, it looks something like this. So all the load in this blue zone is going to the blue beam. Okay, and all the load in this red color zone is going to the red beam. No confusion? Now look at the middle portion. Okay, so if we look at the middle part of the slab here, you can see in this gray color, for this portion of the slab it doesn't matter whether the blue beam is there or not. It really doesn't matter for this particular gray concrete zone, because all the load from this zone is going to go directly to this red color beam here and here. Okay, so it has become clumsy if I separate it out. Okay, so for the middle portion it looks something like this. I have simply eliminated the blue beam for this middle portion of the slab. Okay, so now if you have a slab or a beam like this which is supported at two ends, okay, like this one, how you are actually going to provide the reinforcement? Of course, under any load it will bend and you will have tension at the bottom and compression at top for any type of load. Okay, and you know that concrete is weak in tension, so it will simply crack like this. Okay, to resist all this crack, what you have to do? You have to simply put the reinforcement in place. So first, in the first place, you are going to put the reinforcement along this direction or along the shorter direction, which looks something like this. Okay, then you will provide the reinforcement along the longer direction here. Okay, like this. And the name of this type of bars sometimes is known as distribution bar. So in this type of cross section, it actually looks like this. Agree? So if you find this video useful to understand this basic concept, I know this is very much basic, but it's really confusing. Okay, especially it was for me when I was a beginner. Okay, so if you like this video, please don't forget to share it and also put a thumbs up. And till now, if you have not subscribed, please do it and also press the bell icon.